Yeah, the boys. It's Moe Duwabihi, as you know. And today we're doing something a little different. I thought, you know what? I'm not gonna keep giving you all these stranger addiction videos and stuff like that. I'm gonna tease you a bit, make his way. I can't give him every day, you know what I mean? Plus, I take a lot of effort to edit. So today, I thought, you know what? I put a thing up on Insta. Give me some questions for a Q&A on you. I've never done a Q&A before, so I thought, yeah, let's do one. I don't know how seriously I'm going to answer these questions. I haven't looked at the questions yet. I'm just looking at them now. I don't know how serious I'm going to take these questions. If there's some good questions, I might answer honestly. Or I might just crack jokes. We'll see what happens. First question of the day. First question I got was, where are the bitches at, but? Can I just let you know what I said? Might do my first ever Q&A on YouTube tomorrow. Give me some actually good, interesting, funny questions. Where the bitches at? Where the bitches at? Cause I don't fucking know. Does it look like, you think if I had bitches I'd be sitting in my room talking to a camera? How much maintenance does the mullet need? I shampoo and condition it every day actually. I comb it 3 times a day. No nuts. Cause what do you mean, look at it. I'm naturally set cuz. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Oh, here's a good one. What sauces do you get on your snack pack? Always barbecue. I was about to say garlic. I was about to say barbecue then garlic. Okay. Barbecue, garlic, and chili. There's an ant. Why is there an ant? I get distracted too easy. Those three. If you get anything else besides those three, you know, you can sack chili if you're not into chili. Barbecue and garlic. But if you get anything else, like tomato sauce, you're just ruining the whole snack pack. I don't know how I can say it with tomato sauce. When did you grow the hectic mullet? I grew it in the last year when I decided I'm gonna do a face reveal. Well, I say face reveal, you know what I mean? When I decided I'm gonna do IRL shit at the start of 2020, I was like, I'm gonna start doing IRL shit. And I did it, and now look where we are. Hectic, eh? What's the most illegal or dumbest shit you ever done? Illegal? I haven't done many things, if I'm honest. I torrent a lot of shit. I haven't done much illegal shit, to be honest. Dumb? I've done a lot of dumb shit. Like a stupid amount, a dumb amount of dumb shit. I don't know where to start. Probably the dumbest thing I've ever done. It's not dumb in like the normal sense of like doing something stupid, but the dumbest thing I've ever done was I basically turned down like a ninesome. I swear to God, like with all girls. Like, literally, I could have lost my virginity in like an eightsome, ninesome. Like, I think there was about 8-9 of them. You're probably going to hear the story. So, this is 2017? 2016, end of 2016. I just graduated from high school and I just got into my first relationship. You know what I mean? Legit a week into the relationship we're dating for a while. But we made like official like a week before, or like I think at the beginning of this month. This is at the end of this month. And we go on a cruise, me and my family. My mum and shit don't know. Hopefully they don't watch this shit. It's gonna be weird. But anyways, so I'm 17. I'm 17 at the point, at this time. And there's like a group of schoolie girls. Their room is at the end of this corridor. It's only supposed to be 4 rooms. I think all of them go back this night. They're at the end. We're like a room across, like just more down. We're the second last room. And how it is like, so we had one room, me and my two brothers, and then my mum and my cousin had the other room. They were sharing one. On this cruise, there was a curfew for like, it was I think 1 a.m. for if you were under 18. But the thing is, I mean, look at me. I've been looking like this since I could grow a beard. Like since 17, 16, I looked like this, right? no security guard batted an eye at me. I was up to like whatever time. This is like 4 a.m, we're going back. So I'm walking back down to the corridor. They're in front of me, stumbling shit. They're off their heads, cuz they're fucked. Right? They're fucking sent. All like Aussie girls, bro. Gangers, cuz. But hot, right? And they're going. They don't even notice me yet. They're going into their room. I'm trying to get my key in, but I'm fucking up. Fucking blah, 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 blah. I'm like, I can't do it. And then the last two turn around, right? And they look at me and they're like, oh, you're cute. And I look at them and then I didn't think they were talking to me, because I knew that I wasn't even their age yet, but they obviously didn't know that. And I'm like, I look back and I'm like, oh me. Like there's someone else in the corridor, right? And then they're like, you should come in to our room. You know what I said? Nah, I'm good, thank you. Cuz. Like, I was a virgin at the time as well, if you couldn't tell. Because I was in a relationship for a month, I said no. Which I guess is good. I'm a loyal cunt, but I said no. It doesn't end there. They kept egging it on. Like, come on, come in, come on. I'm like, I can't, I'm gonna go to bed. And they're like, all right, we'll come into your room. The last two of them, two girls were gonna come into my room. My two brothers are sleeping in there. I'm like, nah, it's all right. Don't come in, no, don't. Long story short, I literally just pushed them out of my room because they're trying to get in while my brothers are sleeping. And I turned down literally like 8 girls. And to this day, that is the dumbest thing I've ever done in my fucking life. I regret it every day. I mean, like, I don't regret it because I didn't cheat. But that relationship went to shit like 2 months later. If you were an actor, what movie do you think you'd be in? If I was in a movie, what movie would I be? Because look at me. Scarface. Tony Montana. Isn't obvious? Oh, this is a good one. Watch your parents have sex every day for the rest of your life or join in once. Could I join in every day? Get the fuck out of these questions, bro. Will you ever do a full face reveal? I mean, this is my face though. What do you mean? Like, will I ever take off the sunnies and hat? I don't know. I haven't really decided when I'd ever do it, if I'd ever do it. I'm kind of winging it. So if I don't know. I always joked about 1 million subs. Will I hit that? I don't know. If I do, I guess I'd have to at that point. But would I do it before? Maybe. I don't know. I'm winging it. Maybe when I get to a point where I'm like, yeah, it's time. But I don't think it's time yet. I think we're doing well. Not yet. I love teasing you cunts. It's so funny. Weirdest date you've ever been on? I haven't been on many weird dates. I haven't been on many dates in general. There was a weird girl. Like, weird, bro. She dyed her hair red. You know, if they dye their hair red, they're weird off the bat, right? Because I don't know how I end up going on a date with this girl. But I did. We went with someone movie and stuff. Anyway, it was alright. It was nice. We went to eat. And then she sniffs me. And she doesn't say something like, oh, you smell nice. Or, you know, I love that perfume. What is it? She says, you smell familiar. Uh-huh. And that was it. Not that you smell nice. Like, you're like, you smell familiar. And that was it. And the conversation ended there. That was it. You smell familiar. I'm like, huh? I'm like, what do you say to that? Do I say thank you? You don't say that. It's like, yeah, this is my reaction. Literally, I'm like, ah, thanks. Like, that's it. What gave you the idea, inspiration to start doing YouTube videos and stuff like that? Good question. That's a good question. Basically, I just wanted to get pussy. Hasn't worked yet. Nah, real shit. I've always been into like making videos and editing and shit. My first ever video that I ever dropped, I did it in like 2016. It's private now. It's a COD clip. Like S&D montage. Fucking, it's pretty good. Black Ops 3, I think. Yeah, Black Ops 3. It was alright. Decent. It's privated. Probably gonna stay that way. Cringy as. I call myself the S&D King. I mean, he told me to make it public, maybe. But maybe I'll save it. We'll see. How I started with the Moe stuff. Basically, I knew I always wanted to make videos. Like, just to try it. Because it's just something that's fun. Like, I love doing this shit, right? I remember I was thinking of, like, it wasn't really, like, the first thing I ever did was Moe Don't Worry plays video games, right? In my head, I'm thinking, what if, like, a head from the area, like a full leb cunt, played video games? I thought it'd be funny as, right? But I thought, fuck, someone's probably already done it by now, surely. So I search up Moe Don't Worry Plays, right? Not a video. So I'm like, I'm gonna do it. You know what I'm saying? Literally, I just made a video. The first video I recorded, but it never went out, was a GTA one. And this is how I got Moe Do Worry. I was just playing, and then in the heat of the moment, I'm shooting cops, and I'm like, it's Moe Do Worry, because I'm a fucking problem. And I stopped for a sec, I was like, that's hectic. We're gonna keep that. That's fucking good. And then that never went up. I don't know, the recording went to shit. And then I remember one day I'm like, fuck, I just wanna make this video. I just wanna try it. I think it was the first video I dropped. I think it was like September 25th, 2018. My first YouTube, like Moe. Moe in the Warrior Plays Fortnite. But there's not even game sound on the video. So shit. If you look at the quality then, compared to now, it's been what, 2 years? Crazy shit, bro. Even like my recent gaming ones, like, oh bro, you can tell the growth we've had. The funny thing is, when I started YouTube. Like I never in like my original YouTube name was XKozaiKenGaming. That's my gamer tag on Xbox. I never intended on just doing straight Moe shit. I thought I was gonna do like a lot of other stuff. And then I remember a couple months after, I realized XKozaiKenGaming is a long ass name, right? Like no one's searching that shit up. So I thought, let me suss out other names I can change. So at first I tried XKozaiKen, and then I tried KozaiKen on its own. Then I'm like, for a laugh, because that time I made like I think 4 or 5 videos maybe, and I was only doing Moe Don't Worry Play, like Moe Do Worry Plays, whatever. So I put Moe DW as the name, and that was my third name change. And I tried it, and I looked at it, I'm like, nah, we'll go back to XKozaiKen. And I go to change it, and then it says unable to change. I'm like, whoa, why? I'm like, why? Why is that? And then I realized right underneath it says you have 3 changes every 90 days. I'm like, oh shit, fuck. And then at that point I'm like, well, I guess I'm Moe Don't Worry for 90 days. And then at that moment, I don't know why, but I'm like, I have to make an Insta. I don't know why, but I had to do it. It just in my head, I just had to make one. So I made an Insta. I started posting my gaming clips on there. I got a shout out from a page that had like 2,000 followers, Turkish Leber Memes. That got me up. I remember from that day, I only had like 9 subs, I think at that point, and like 6 were family and friends. I got up to like 20 something subs before I went to bed. It was crazy. Like the day after I posted, it was fucking, I was like hitting 20. So I was like, bro, what the fuck? I was cheering cuz. And then I was just doing straight game. And then I started doing memes because I couldn't upload gaming videos every day because my laptop was shit. I couldn't start to edit. It was a hassle. So I'm like, I'll do something, I wanted to keep posting content. So I just did memes, and then I became a meme page, basically. Then I'm like, yeah, fuck memes, I'm over it. I went back to just gaming, and then I'm like, at the end of 2019, like New Year's Eve, and like I said, I was gonna do a surprise. I did like the face reveal, and then I'm like, yeah, IRL shit. And now we're here. And we still got a long way to go, but I've got a long way, it's crazy. But yeah, to answer the question, what gave me the idea inspiration? Literally like nothing. I felt like it. I just felt like trying it out because it looked fun and it is. How much money do you make off YouTube? Good question. Honest answer, none. I make money now. I do get ads, but you don't get much money off it. I've made like maybe, I got monetized in June. I've made like $100, maybe about 150 now. But the thing is, the videos that are getting a lot of views, like the Strange Addiction shit now, they don't get monetized. I think they get ads on them, but the revenue goes to TLC, like the owners, they all get copyright striked, every video. I make no money, like nothing at all. I just do them because one, they're fun to make, two, you guys love it. And yeah, it helps me grow a shit ton. They just help me grow, and they really, like you guys love it, so I'm gonna keep doing it. But I make nothing off it, like that's for free. Okay, but then again, all up to this point has been for free. I've made like nothing on it. But yeah, pretty much at this point, I'm making nothing. Are you bringing back GTA? Ooh, I don't know. The thing is with my videos, I don't like doing the same thing over and over and over. As you probably noticed, I've changed up a lot of my videos. Like every few months, I just change up what I'm doing. I haven't done a gaming one since the last 5 nights. And that's only because it was horror. I haven't done a, when was the last time I did an actual gaming video on Xbox, you know, GTA? I don't know. The thing is with that, I don't want it to be repetitive. The GTA videos, look, if you really want one, I could probably feel one. I could probably do one for you. I'll do another one. Maybe another like last big one. I'll probably do another one in the future, we'll see. But if you want me to do a GTA one, let me know. I'll try and make it funny. But if you go through, like, I don't want it to be too repetitive because I'll do the same shit over and over. But if that's what you want, let me know. And I might just do another GTA video. Any advice on life? You're asking me for life advice? I'm a 21-year-old that talks to a camera. I don't know, man. I don't feel like I've lived long enough to really give much advice. But if there's anything I've learned, is bro, when shit happens, life moves on. Like I haven't been through like the hardest. I had a pretty good upbringing. Obviously, shit happened in the family and stuff. But I've noticed whenever I go through something, like a few months down the line, it's like it didn't even happen. You know what I mean? So whenever I go through something now, I just think about, in like a year's time, is this even gonna matter? And then it's probably not. Or like another good saying, if it's not gonna affect you in 5 years, don't let it bother the next 5 minutes, you know what I mean? Fuck, why'd I get so deep? I don't know, any advice on life? Fuck, bitches get money, cuz, 80. You know what, there's a good saying. 50 Cent said it in a song, I can't remember the exact quote. And it goes something, you know what, I'll get it up, one sec. Okay, here's the quote. Homie, You hustling backwards if you chasing a bitch. Stupid. Chase the paper, they come with the shit. Exactly. Chase the money, the bitches come with it. Okay, it's not an answer. I live by that. What's the reason you started doing comedy skits? Because I felt like, honestly, like, not to sound like a hardcore, I felt like it. It's just, I don't know, with this video stuff, if I'm not enjoying it, I'm going to stop. And that's why, like, with the gaming things, I was kind of getting over it, because it's just, I knew I could do better content, like with IRL, like these kind of stuff, especially like the reactions and shit. I knew I could do much better things than just gaming, so I'm like, yeah, I'm going to sack it for a bit. And then comedy skits, I just felt like I had some skit ideas, I thought I'd try them out. Which reminds me, the latest skit I did, the driller. You're still waiting on that song, aren't you? Coming soon. It's a fucking top Jewel song, cause I swear I'm gonna be a rapper. What? I swear, watch. I'm hectic, cause I'm hectic. Oh, anyways, I've been recording for almost half an hour now. I don't know if I'm gonna put every question in. I'm probably gonna, cause that's a long video for a Q&A. I don't know how entertaining this is. If it's entertaining, you want me to do more, let me know. But I don't know. I thought I'd try something different. I like to try different things, see how you guys react. If you like it, I'll keep doing it. If not, I might keep doing it if I feel like it, but I'll probably sack it, to be honest. Let me know. If you have any other questions, if you do want it and you want to leave questions like in the comments, I could put them there. I might do another one. And yeah, just thanks for watching. Thanks for all the support recently. Bro, recently, I hit 3K last Tuesday. We're at like 3,700. It took me months to get from 2 to 3. And like, I'm past halfway in just a week. Oh, I hit halfway in like a week. Which is fucking, like, that is crazy. You know how crazy that is to me? Like, that is insane, bro. So thank you so much. And all the comments, like all the comments you guys do, I think I'm underrated and stuff. I appreciate it. Like, thank you. Like, I actually love you. That's like crazy. But yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, the fucking boys. Latest.